Hello, welcome back. Fit us in here at Caffeinated Gaming, taking a last look from Neverwinter Beta Weekend 2. This is going to be a Control Wizard's perspective from Cloak Tower. It's the first dungeon, the level 16, the third bit of group content in the game, at least currently. There's two skirmishes before that. There's an 8 and a 13. Not going to go through the entire dungeon. We're going to kind of pick and choose. I just want to show a little bit of group content, a couple of the bigger bosses, and the fact that the looting seems to be working. Didn't have any issues this time. Also, I did want to point out that this is a group that I did group with a rogue. Noticed that even though I'm trying really hard to do lots of damage, I can't compete with rogues. Which, to me, we'll have to see how, if there's a balance issue. I don't think so. I think I offered a little extra utility. And, you know, the ability to do damage at range. And just, you know, some of the crowd control available to this class makes me think that the wizard might be better. Well, might be balanced. A lot of people would say, well, the rogue does more damage, therefore they're better. I don't know if that's true. That and also the rogue being in melee, kind of a risk. You know, a lot of bosses like to drop AoEs, they have to reposition. And since you cannot use abilities while on the move, having to be in melee can be a little bit dangerous too. They're just kind of watching that. I'm going to hit X occasionally to look at that. The damage meter, it has more than damage, but I'm just kind of curious. I wanted to do a direct comparison to someone that was playing that class. So I played Rogue Trickster in the first beta. They seem to do lots of damage. It seems like I'm doing less now, and it was being supported by this group. I'm finding I'm doing about probably between 50 and 75% of the damage that they are. Although a couple of my abilities I'm using, I don't necessarily need to be using in here. I mean, for one, my knockback. I really shouldn't be using it, but I have it, and it does some damage in an AoE. But really doesn't do too much. It's kind of useful in harder fights to keep things away from the priests, but not that big of a deal. You can see the pacing of this dungeon's pretty fast. I think it said 45-minute estimated time on the queue screen. This video is 27 minutes and 9 seconds, so seems like it's about 25-35 minutes in reality. Okay, is that a wizard or a priest? I couldn't tell. Watch out for that circle. You can blink through that, thankfully. Got some bigger guys here. This is a, seems like a fairly quick dungeon. We also have these lootable points. Everyone has a skill. In my case, it's Arcane Lore. You can use it to loot these nodes, which give you resources for crafting. One thing you can do, they change it a little bit. You have kits that, in the previous beta, they give you a temporary buff that gave you access to that skill. In this beta, they're kits that you use to do cross-class. Like, I could have a Dungeoneering kit, which lets me use a Dungeoneering item 65% of the time. The other 35% just outright fails. And I don't get the buff for 2 minutes. I actually only get to use one kit per item, so it's a little more costly to be using kits on everything, so you kind of have to pick and choose. Is it worth it? It probably is, and it might not be. Especially at low level, where they're like a silver and change each. You gotta save early on for a companion and a horse, which is like 3 gold right there. That's a good portion of money. Guess I could have used Astral Diamond, since kind of back in the game early on I did get a little bit of decent amount of Astral Diamonds, actually. We'll look into that system more, hopefully in the next beta. Hopefully I'll get a higher enough level to actually kind of use it. The first time I saw any decent Astral gear was like 30 or 40, so this beta did go to 40. I only made it to 19 or 20. Alright, let's see what's behind this door. Well, in this room. Actually, this room looks a little like Karazhan. I played WoW during Burning Crusade, and kind of like the little library area. It reminds me of that. Need some water. And I'm recording this on the day that, on the 11th, so I'm still looking forward to StarCraft beta, but need coffee. I haven't had a coffee for 2 days now. Alright, now that that's over. By the time this gets posted, chances are StarCraft will have been up for a few days, and I'll probably be sleep-deprived, and hopefully be finished with the Brutal campaign pretty soon. So I hope everyone's enjoying it. I'm sure there'll be plenty of people that are annoyed about the ladder, because, let's face it, most of us think we know how to play the ladder. Most of us don't have a clue. Most of us suck. Only the top 7% are diamond. Of them, only the top 2% of those, I think, are masters. And only 200 per region are grandmasters. So most of us really just aren't top-tier players that know how to use all the tools available to us. So as much as people want to bitch and moan about balance in that game, at least in the ladder, chances are the only thing we really have to complain about is how difficult it is to learn a race rather than how good a race performs, because we really don't know what we're doing. But hopefully overall everyone's having fun with that. I'm sure the ladder's... I'm looking forward to the story too. It might have been a little bit cheesy, but I'm still thinking it's going to be good. And in case I'm not doing it yet, my plans for it are the Brutal campaign. I will upload the video of whenever I'm successful at completing the mission, and then I'll probably do outtakes for when I have issues. So that way I won't be uploading videos constantly. They won't be really, really long. But I won't just go and say, yeah, I one-shot everything in the Brutal campaign, because I know for a fact that won't happen. Even though I'm hoping it's Zerg-focused, since it's Heart of the Swarm and all, and I'm a Zerg player. I know in Wings of Liberty I did... There were a few missions that were like, holy crap! Like the friggin' lava mission. There we go. Maybe if they do something kind of fun like they did in the first campaign where you got like the Lost Viking. I went ahead and worked on getting Lost Viking gold. Maybe I can try to do specialty events like that too. Eventually I'm going to start trying to work on a video about a mediocre player aiming to get to Masters, but that might be a little ways off. I might just do one video a day, a few days a week of ladder play, basically focusing on my goals for improvement and seeing if they work. Alright, we're going to go and do this guy, and then I'm probably going to skip forward to the next boss. I think the next boss might be the boss of the dungeon. I'm not going to show the whole thing. I showed it in the previous beta weekend, so I'll just skip forward after this. This guy's pretty straightforward. In fact, most of the encounters in this first area are really easy. I've heard in interviews that the difficulty does ramp up. I mean, think about the first dungeon in Warcraft. That was pretty darn easy. Can't remember what's at. I played Horde, so it's the one in the Barrens. It's the one with the Chuck Norris jokes, right? Actually, I haven't played since the Cataclysm, so I don't know what the new world looks like. And suddenly minions. Lots of minions. This is where my knockback actually might come in handy to keep him off that priest. It's a dwarf priest, of course. Gotta be stout. Ooh, I got a blue item. Probably from the boss. We'll look at that in a minute. You get a lot of time before it's a look. My guess is it's probably a clothing piece with armor. Click on that. Yeah, I'm gonna greed on it. My thinking is defensive items I greed on. I let kind of warriors have a priority on them. So let's fast forward to the big boss fight. Alright, this is the end of Cloak Tower. We're probably 20 to 23 minutes into the dungeon. Like I said, fairly fast paced. Not quite the same as some other MMOs I've played lately that really just don't have trash. This one definitely does, but it's not going to be like hours and hours long. The game definitely has a bit of a Terra feel. From what I've heard, people basically comparing Terra to this game. Terra's combat is better, but a lot of people just like the Forgotten Realms and D&D name, so. And the fact that this is free-to-play. Terra, remember, it came out, it was a full-price game with a subscription. It went free-to-play recently, but I think you still have to buy it, don't you? Overall, the game is enjoyable. It is not innovative. It's nothing all that new. It does a good job of combat. The combat's fast-paced, it's fun, but if you've played MMOs before and if you've played anything recent, like Guild Wars 2 that has more of the action style to role-playing games, you probably will feel like it's nothing all that new and innovative, but my opinion's always been gaming is very iterative. If you try to redo everything, it's probably not going to work too well all the time. I'm thinking Warhammer Online, where they tried to just completely redesign how people leveled in that game and included the PQ system, public questing, and it was interesting for a bit, and it turned out to be really nothing different. Heck, Guild Wars 2 said the same thing. There was going to be no Trinity, there was going to be no grinding and questing, and really it's the same thing too. So games that try to do something different often find that they're not all that different, or they fail in trying. So usually I would figure, do something well and offer something just a little bit different. Don't just try to reinvent the game. And so far, I think they're offering a really solid title that's free to play, and the combat's fun. If you're a fan of Terra and you like the depth of combat Terra, you'll probably prefer that one over this, but if you maybe want something a little more action-oriented, never tried it before, and you want a free-to-play game, check out this game, because once it goes live, it is free-to-play. In fact, I think the beta weekends are a little easier to get into now. I don't think you have to get the Founders Packs anymore. I believe that's a Priest daily power there that's healing everyone in it. I'm not positive. I haven't played a Priest yet. I probably should try playing all the classes just to get a basic understanding of them. See, this guy does drop summon lots of adds. I was trying to sort of crowd control him a little bit, but I'm also using a decent amount of my right click. My right click currently, oh, there he goes. It hits, and on the third hit, it does an AoE, so some area effect damage. You can see that rogue just destroyed me on damage, but I was second place. So if you want a pure DPS class, go rogue. If you want range with some utility, then go wizard. If you want a healer, well, you got a priest, and warrior. And whatever the fifth class is. I'm looking forward to seeing what they announce for the fifth class. And here's the part that I'm happy about. Yes, it works. Last time I ran Cloak Tower, I ran it twice. The first time, it bugged out, and we basically just sat here at the ground level, like screwing around, pushing all of these little lore items until eventually it worked. Second time I ran it, nothing. It didn't. The chest wasn't up, and you couldn't leave because you hadn't looted the chest. So it seems like they fixed that. I did have an issue in one of the skirmishes not being able to leave, but it appears that looting seems to be fixed. This guy's offering me a foundry quest. I've actually already done that quest. I wonder if I can repeat it. But that's it for Neverwinter from Weekend 2. Weekend 3 is in 2 weeks. I'm looking forward to trying it out. Hopefully after that, if you're still interested in playing and haven't had a chance, they'll go into open beta. Here's to hoping they do that in April. I'd love to see the game launch soon, because it's tons of fun. It feels like it's just about finished, so. And I'm looking forward to seeing what people can come up with in the Foundry. That's the system I'm really interested in. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned to more videos. StarCraft 2, Infinity Wars, obviously. Probably might try some CD at some point, if it stops being garbage. Sorry, I'm still pissed off that I tried to log in one afternoon and spent half an hour in queue. It reset the queue, and then the servers came down. I was a little annoyed. So, game is fun, but I'm going to try it again when it's fixed. Anyway, thanks for watching. Stay tuned to more. You got anything you want to yell at me about? Please do. Hopefully I haven't been drinking my coffee too loudly lately. Oh, look. If you're curious, that's enchanting. Get the runes. I actually upgraded 3 to make a higher level rune, but more on that next beta. See you guys next time.